I'm Lauren from the Richmond Arts Center, and I'm really glad you're here. We're going to get to do some really fun stuff today. And the thing we're going to think about today is making art with circles. And if you look around, there are so many circles everywhere. Like, look right here, the lantern. And here's a bell, and it has a circle. Come on into my studio, and we'll look for more circles. Here's a world. It's a big circle. We're all on this big circle together. Oh, look at this. Here's a vase. It has a silly guy on it. And it has a circle that's big on the top and little on the bottom. That's my bicycle. It has lots of circles. The wheels, the part here that's for the chain.
I thought it would be fun to paint a big circle. So let's go.
When you make art, it's really important that you have a clean space. This is my table, and it is a big mess, so I'm going to have to clean it up so I have a spot to work. But you can work in your kitchen, or in your room, or outside, anywhere where it's nice and clean, and that you have time and space to concentrate. Now I have a clean spot to work in. So let's get ready to work. We're going to need some supplies.
These are the things I'd like you to go collect. If you have them, ballpoint pen, a pencil sharpener, some plain copy paper, some paper bags, magazines or recycled paper if you have them, and cardboard boxes that are also great for opening up and drawing on.
I'm gonna put out the next materials that if you have them, great, and if you don't, that's okay too.
Here are the extra materials just in case you happen to have them. Some crayons, some colored pencils, some colored pens, glue stick, and some scissors. And then, if you happen to have a cardboard box to put all your stuff in, that would be awesome. And remember, you might need an older person to help you.
Plain paper, that's okay. Take your food box, open it up, and then you can cut off the sides and get some really nice paper to draw with.
Guys get to be investigators in your circle hunt. Look around your house for circles. We found a toilet paper roll, a roll of tape, candles, CDs, even a chapstick. And look at that, a beautiful tin to hold cookies.
So take a little bit of time and shut the computer off and go find some circles and bring them back.
Go ahead and find your circles in your house.
Hey guys, welcome back. I hope you had a successful treasure hunt with your circles. So let's go over some of the circles that I found. First off, in this clock, look at that. There's a circle here, a circle here, and a bunch of tiny little circles all around the edges. You can also see there's a circle in the 10 and in the 8. Where can you find circles and numbers? Oh my god, and a rubber band. That has a circle. See if I put it down on the paper? That's a circle, isn't it? And even on my wrist, there's the scrunchies. And that's a circle right in there. So, if you guys really want to become official artists, we need to take the artist pledge. Because even though a lot of people want to be perfect, nobody's perfect. And we need to remember that even if we don't really like what we made, everyone makes mistakes. And we can always fix our mistakes or just leave them as they are. Because some of the most beautiful things in life, they are mistakes.
Abracadabra! I'm back. That was my daughter, Mirabai, who you got to meet. She's a real expert at circles, isn't she? So she was talking about the artist pledge, and I just want to share that with you because I think it's really great. Put your one hand up, and here we go. I can make messes.
I can make messes.
I can make mistakes.
I can make mistakes.
But deep inside.
But deep inside.
I got what it takes.
I got what it takes.
I'm an artist.
I'm an artist.
Awesome.
Now let's move on to our next step. Make sure you have your circles.
Now we're going to take all the circles that we found and we're going to trace them onto our paper. So I'll show you what tracing is. Here's my paper and here are some of the things that I found. Uh-oh, where's my pencil? Oh, there it is, my polka dot pencil. I love my polka dot pencil. I'm going to press it down and I'm going to go ahead and trace my circle. Now, you might need a grown-up to help you. I don't know. This is my peanut butter jar. You can see it, now I have a tracing. So I'm going to lay down my other things that I found.
When you're tracing, remember to not have your circles touch. You want to have circles, but they shouldn't be touching yet. I hope you found lots of circles to trace, and I hope that you trace them. I traced them in pen so you could see them, and they're all not touching, and they're all different sizes. What do I mean by that? Well, here's a lid to a jar, and inside is this part of the lid. So it's a circle inside a circle. We're gonna trace our circle inside a circle. So I'm gonna get my colored pencil this time, and I'm gonna find something that can go in the middle of that. So I'm gonna take this jar lid and I'm gonna put it here and I'm gonna trace that circle. So now I have a circle inside a circle. So as you can see, these are the big circles. It's the middle circle and the smaller circle. And there's lots of smaller circles inside my big circle. So now you want to fill in the smaller circles. So remember, if you don't have colored pens or anything like that, you can use your regular pencil. And I'm going to take my smallest one. And one thing you could do is you could shade. So I can make one side darker. And then I can get lighter. So that's kind of nice to be able to shade.
You can fill in all your small circles with patterns, spirals, checkers, whatever you want.
Now that I have this, the next thing I'm going to do, and then I have my circles inside my circles, is I could go ahead and maybe think about my background. This is the background, is the part that's behind all the circles, and I think that I'd like to fill it in. So I'm going to take my crayon, and I have a blue crayon, and I'm just going to go around in my background and fill it in. And then if I want, I can go back over things. And then I can, if I want to leave that, I can. Or I could try doing more circles inside of circles. Circles inside of circles inside of circles. So that's circles inside of circles and with more circles. And if I want, then I could go ahead and fill those in. And I can make them solid. I can make them open. I can put a pattern on them. It's really up to me. But now you have your circle hunt drawing.
Even if you don't have colored pencils and pens, you can use food boxes and ballpoint pens and make your own beautiful work.
Thought it would be fun to share with you the abstract artist whose name is Kandinsky. He works a lot with colors, shapes, and he uses a lot of circles, as you can see here.
So I'm really glad that we got to spend this time together. I had a great time. So we got to do circle movement. We got to go on a circle hunt. We got to trace circles. We got to put circles, and I love this one, circles inside of circles. And we got to work on our background, and we made a beautiful piece of art that we can share with our family and friends and neighbors. And you could put your name down there. I forgot to put my name on there, but you can. And so I hope that you will do more art, and maybe you can send a picture to the Art Center, which is where I teach. I love art, and I love the Art Center, and that you'll do just a lot more art at home. So I'm going to say goodbye. My circle is going to say goodbye. My circle glasses are going to say goodbye. My circle shirt is going to say goodbye. Oh! My circle socks are going to say goodbye. And my magic circle pencil is going to say goodbye. But I'll see you soon, and we'll do something with art and more circles. Okay, bye-bye.